Welcome, dear students. Today we will see partition coefficient of iodine in water and carbon tetrachloride. Aim of practical: to determine partition coefficient of iodine in water and carbon tetrachloride. Requirements: chemicals required to conduct this experiment, iodine crystals, carbon tetrachloride, 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate, 0.1 normal 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate, and distilled water. Then apparatus: separating funnel, reagent bottles, beakers, burette stand, then burette, conical flask, and electronic weighing balance. Partition coefficient is defined as the ratio of extent, distribution, or partition of your drug between two immiscible layer or solvents. So in this two immiscible layer, one will be your aqueous solvent and second will be your organic solvent. Partition coefficient is also known as distribution coefficient because your drug is distributing into the two different solvents which are immiscible with each other. It is a distribution of solute such as iodine between solvents, carbon tetrachloride and water. The molecular phase of iodine is similar that of I2 in both carbon tetrachloride and water. The partition coefficient increases with increase in a concentration of solute particle in a solvent, but with the presence of water and carbon tetrachloride as a solvent, the solution is diluted and thus partition coefficient will not change with concentration of solvent in a dilute solution. While a distribution law states the distribution of solute particle equally among the two immiscible solvent with diluted concentration, and hence distribution law may be applied to this experiment. Then physical and chemical properties of iodine. Iodine is a non-metallic, nearly black solid at a room temperature and has a glittering crystalline appearance. The molecular lattice contain discrete diatomic molecules which are also present in a molten and gaseous states. Iodine has a moderate vapor pressure at a room temperature and in an open vessel slowly sublimates to a deep violet vapor that is irritating to eye, nose and throat, and if highly concentrated vapors are there, then they are the poisonous. They may cause a serious damage for the skin and tissues. For this reason, iodine is best weighted in a stoppered bottle, and the iodine molecule can act as a Lewis acid in that it combined with various Lewis bases. The interaction is weak, however, and a few solid complexes have been isolated. The complexes are easily detected in solution and are referred to as charge transfer complexes. So iodine, it acts as a Lewis acid and it form a complex with number of Lewis base. Then we'll see actual procedure of experiment. Prepare approximately 110 ml saturated solution of iodine in carbon tetrachloride and use it as a stock solution. Then prepare following mixtures four reagent bottles and label them as A, B, C, and D. So in bottle A, we require to take 50 ml distilled water, 40 ml stock solution and 10 ml carbon tetrachloride. In bottle B, take 50 ml distilled water, 30 ml stock solution and 20 ml carbon tetrachloride. For bottle C, in bottle C, take a 50 ml distilled water, 20 ml stock solution and 30 ml carbon tetrachloride. Then in bottle D, take a 50 ml distilled water, 10 ml stock solution and 40 ml carbon tetrachloride. So likewise, we have to prepare this mixture. Then place a stopper on each bottle and check them for 30 minutes. For better and reproducible results, effective shaking is must. Then transfer the mixture in a separating funnel and label this separating funnel as A, B, C and D. Then allow them to stand for the 10 minutes to separate organic and aqueous layer. Close top end of pipette and insert its lower tip in organic layer through this upper aqueous layer and withdraw 10 ml sample and transfer to iodometric flask. Then add 10 ml 10% wet by volume solution of potassium iodide and titrate 10 ml from this solution against 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate using starch indicator. Endpoint is pink color of organic layer disappears. Then pipette out 10 ml upper aqueous layer using dry pipette and titrate against 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate using 2 to 3 drops of starch as an indicator. And endpoint is blue color of aqueous layer disappears. Repeat same process for all remaining samples, that is B, C and D sample. Then note down the readings. Now we'll see actual demonstration of practical.
Of determination of partition coefficient of iodine into water and carbon tetrachloride. So glassware is required to perform this experiment. We read stand, burette, then volumetric flask, then iodine flask, then measuring cylinder, beaker, then glass rod, rubber bulb, pipette and reagent bottle, then separating funnel and tripod stack. Then chemicals required to perform this experiment: iodine, then starch indicator, then 10% potassium iodide, then distilled water and carbon tetrachloride, and last one is 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfite and 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. Now I am going to prepare a saturated solution of iodine into the carbon tetrachloride. Before on this saturated solution, I am taking 110 ml of carbon tetrachloride. this is 110 mm carbon tetrachloride. Now I am going to add this iodine into the carbon tetrachloride. With the help of glass rod, we have to mix it. Then with color solution, prepare. Slowly, slowly, you have to add this iodine into this carbon tetrachloride. And prepare saturated solution of iodine into this carbon tetrachloride. My saturated solution is ready to use. I move to the next step. Now, next process is preparation of soap solution. Here I have taken 4 reagent bottle and this reagent bottle labeled as A, B, C and D. In each reagent bottle, I am going to add 50 ml of distiller. Then in bottle C, I am adding same amount of water, that is 50 ml, and into bottle B also I am adding 50 ml distilled water. Then this stock solution I am adding in this 4 reagent bottle. So in first reagent bottle I am adding 40 ml stock solution. Into bottle B, I am adding 30 ml in bottle B, 30 ml stock solution. Then into bottle C, 20 ml. And bottle D, 10 ml. So this is 20. I am adding it into the C bottle. And last one, B bottle. And I am adding 10 ml of stock solution of iodine into the carbon tetrachloride. Now I am adding this carbon tetrachloride in each bottle. So quantity for bottle A is 10 ml. Then for bottle B, 20 ml. Then for bottle C, 30 ml. And bottle 4, 40 ml. Now I have added distilled water, stock solution and carbon tetrachloride in each bottle into the different proportion. So my reagent water, I am going to check it for the distribution of iodine into the aqueous as well as organic layer. So likewise, I have to check it for the 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, I will transfer this mixture into the separating funnel for the separation of aqueous and organic layer. Now I have shaken all these four bottles 30 minutes. Now I am going to transfer this mixture into this separating funnel with the help of funnel. Contents from the bottle B into this separating funnel. It is also labeled as B. For the separation of aqueous and organic layer, when you transfer it into this separating funnel, it is easy to separate aqueous and organic layer. Now we'll keep this separating funnel as it is for the 10 minutes, then there will be separation of phases, organic and aqueous phase. Remove this aqueous and organic layer and titrate it against the sodium thiosulfate. Now this separating funnel consists of upper aqueous layer and lower organic layer. Now with the help of pipette, without disturbing your aqueous layer, slowly you have to separate out your organic layer from bottom of this separating funnel. Into this organic layer, you require to add 10 ml potassium iodide. So first of all, I wash this pipette, then I take potassium iodide 10 ml. then this 10 mm potassium iodide, I'm adding into this organic layer. Now from these, I am taking 10 ml into iodine flask. And I am titrating against 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate by using starch as an indicator. Slowly color of iodine is disappearing. Now my solution is colorless. Likewise, you have to separate out this organic layer with the help of pipette. Now we have to transfer pipette through this aqueous layer into this organic layer, and slowly you have to remove this organic layer with the help of pipette. Do not disturb this aqueous layer. Similarly, you have to proceed for the C and D and titrate your organic layer with 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate. There might be the chances of sublimation of your organic solvent and evaporation of iodine from this separating funnel when we use this knob for the separation of this lower layer. So that's why we are using pipette to separate out that organic layer from the bottom of separating funnel. Similarly, you have to remove this aqueous layer with the help of pipette. And titrate this aqueous layer against the 0.01 sodium thiosulfate. Adding this starch indicator into this aqueous layer and titrating it against 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. So color will be disappear when you add this sodium thiosulfate. Now this colored solution is converted into the colorless form. Colorless layer is converted into the colorless solution. Likewise, you have to separate out aqueous layer from this B, C and D separating funnel and titrate it against 0.01 not one normal sodium thiosulfate and note down the readings.
Now we'll see observations and observation table. This V organics, these readings A, B, C, D, these are observed reading when I titrate this bottle A contained, an organic layer of this bottle A contained B, C and D. Then this V aqueous, these are the readings obtained from the after titration of aqueous layer against 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. V organic, volume of 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate per 10 ml of organic layer. Then V aqueous, volume of 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate for 10 ml of aqueous layer. N organic is the normality of organic layer. N aqueous, normality of aqueous layer. C organic, concentration of iodine in organic layer is equal to normality. And C aqueous, that is concentration of iodine in the aqueous layer. And K is nothing but partition coefficient of iodine. For aqueous layer, concentration of iodine in bottle A, that is N aqueous value, we can calculate by using N1V1 is equal to N2V2 equation. So N1 is a normality of iodine. V1, volume of aqueous layer taken into this iodometric flask. Then N2 is normality of NaOH and V2 is burette reading. Then for the determination of C aqueous value, we can use this formula 0.01, that is strength of sodium thiosulfate. V2 is burette reading and 126.90, that is molecular weight of iodine divided by 10. That is volume of your aqueous layer. So by using this formula, we can calculate amount of iodine moles per liter into the solution. Then here I put a value of this V2, that is 1.8. Then normality of iodine is 0.0018 normal. Then C aqueous value of iodine for first bottle, it is 0.2284 moles per liter. Similarly, you can calculate this N aqueous and C aqueous values for bottle B, C and D. Now we'll see how to calculate N organic and C organic value. Same way you have to calculate N1V1 is equal to N2V2. Then C organic value we can calculate by using this equation 0.1 into V2 into 126.90 divided by 10. Then this value of C organic will be into the moles per liter. For organic layer, first obtained reading was 10.5. So here I put this 10.5. Then my final answer is 105 normal. So this is normality for the bottle A. Then C organic value is calculated by using same formula 0.1, that is strength of your sodium thiosulfate, 10.5. That is V2 value, that is burette reading, how much amount of sodium thiosulfate required to neutralize 10 ml of organic layer. This is molecular weight of iodine divided by 10. That is volume of your organic layer. Then final answer is 13.32 moles per liter. So we can calculate partition coefficient by using formula C aqueous divided by C organic. So value of C aqueous is 0.2284 and C organic, that is 13.32. So final value K is 0.017. So similarly, calculate N organic and C organic values for bottle B, C and D. In above table, I have calculated all these values. Then mean partition coefficient. A K value for each bottle is calculated. So for the bottle A, it is 0.017, bottle B, 0.018, bottle C, 0.014, and bottle D, 0.013. So here I have taken average of this all four partition coefficient values, and final average value is 0.015. Result: the partition coefficient of iodine in water and carbon tetrachloride was found to be 0.015. Then question bank for the synopsis and viva. First question: what is partition coefficient? The ratio of concentration of solute into immiscible or slightly miscible liquids or into a solid when it is in an equilibrium across the interface between them. Then why only iodometric flask is used while titrating organic layer? So answer is, iodine and carbon tetrachloride can evaporate from normal conical flask and may change concentration of iodine. So iodometric flask is used for the titration. Then third question, why octanol is used to determine partition coefficient? The partition coefficient is used to provide a picture of how a drug distributed itself between the organic and aqueous phases and of the body. Since our blood and fluids are aqueous, the protein and fats that the drug penetrate through or attach to are organic. So basically, octanol is a simple and accurate model for the body's organic phase. That's why octanol is used for the determination of partition coefficient. Why lower organic layer is not withdraw from stopcock of the separating funnel? Because lower organic layer is not withdraw from the stopcock, because evaporation of carbon tetrachloride and sublimation of iodine may change a concentration of iodine into this organic layer. That's why with the help of pipette, you have to separate out the organic layer. Don't use the stopcock. Then what are the applications of partition coefficients? Solubility of drug in water and other solvent can be predicted. Extraction of drug from biological fluids such as blood, tissue and urine can be obtained sufficiently. Effective concentration of preservatives can be predicted for the storage of emulsion and other dosage form. Drug absorption in vivo can be predicted. The N-octanol and water system is used for the determination of partition coefficient, and this system is mimic the lipid membrane and water system found in the body. Release of drugs from ointments and creams can be predicted. In the context of pharmacodynamic, the hydrophobic effect is a major driving force for binding the drugs to the receptor targets. It is advisable to make the drug as a hydrophilic as a possible while it still retains adequate binding affinity to the therapeutic protein target. Then state Nernst distribution law. If solute X distributes itself between two immiscible solvents, that is A and B, at a constant temperature, X is in the same molecular condition into the both solvents. So we can write it as the concentration of X in A divided by concentration of X in B is equal to KD. If C1 denotes concentration of solute in solvent A and C2, that is concentration of solute in solvent B, Then Nernst distribution law can be expressed as C1 divided by C2 is equal to KD, where this KD is called distribution coefficient or partition coefficient or distribution ratio. So this is all about partition coefficient of iodine into water and carbon tetrachloride. Thank you.